Next, we move into Part B5, Cross Connection Control. There have been major changes to this part for 2022, and a new DTS, Specification 41, has been added that prescribes hazard ratings for a limited list of known hazards. Scenarios and hazard ratings were elevated from the informative appendix in ASNZ 3500.1 in NCC 2019. You will remember the old appendix F we all loved. The new work has been updated, and the list of hazards which have not been reviewed since they were first included have now changed. These scenarios and the allocated hazard ratings have now been reviewed and updated for NCC 2022 to ensure that the appropriate level of protection is applied. So firstly, let's look at Part B5 in a little detail. What do these changes look like? Well, firstly, we have a performance requirement. Water services must be designed and installed so as to operate in a way that avoids the likelihood of contamination of any part of the drinking water supply and minimises any adverse impact on the building occupants, the network utility operator's infrastructure, property and the environment. We have added a verification method for assessment of hazard ratings, more on this shortly, plus added a number of the DTS provisions. One provision I want to specifically bring to your attention is the new DTS for 2022, which is B5D5, Unprotected Water Service. It is where pipework and outlets supplied by a drinking water source downstream of an individual protection backflow prevention device are considered to convey drinking water from an unprotected water service. Another is B5D6, Rainwater, which refers the user back to a clause in ASNZS 3500.1 2018 that covers backflow provisions for rainwater. This new clause does not change the stringency from NCC 2019. It just adds it and makes it a lot clearer and easier to find. Introducing Specification 41, new for 2022. This year we have introduced a standalone specification for prescribing hazard ratings for known hazards. As I mentioned earlier, it is sort of replaces the old Appendix F that was previously seen in ASNZS 3500.1. The hazard ratings prescribed in this specification must be used for selecting the required backflow prevention device for the purposes of compliance with the deemed to satisfy provisions. Let's go into it deeper, shall we? In Specification 41 in NCC 2022, we identify some of the more known hazards into protection types like individual, zone, and containment. The diagram on the slide clearly identifies how these types relate to an installation. It is important to note, in some jurisdictions, regulations issued under the water supply legislation and/or rules set out by the network utility operator may prescribe containment protection, which differs from this specification. This is a sample from S41C4 High Hazard Installations, equipment for the purpose of identifying individual protection. You'll see a mix of new hazards and some other hazards that have been updated since the last 2019 NCC. Specification 41 contains over 60 separate installations across low, medium and high hazard ratings, and each with the hazard rating and protection requirements shown. But I need to reiterate that this is a DTS provision, so needs to be followed. But no matter how extensive the list or how long it grows, there will always be new and innovative products that come to the market. So, where a situation arises which is not listed in Specification 41, the appropriate hazard rating may be determined as a performance solution. This performance solution can be developed using verification B5V1. Let's move on to the verification method part of the compliance level. This is another example of where we move from a DTS to a performance solution. B5V1, and following the clause numbering that we've seen, the V for verification method, part B for water services, 5 for cross connection control, and V for verification method. The verification method is a risk assessment tool that can be used to assess the level of risk posed by an installation. As the slide states, a hazard exists wherever it is possible for a water service to be contaminated by an actual or potential cross-connection. So your risk assessment must include potential cross-connections. The introduction of Specification 41 is really exciting because now we have a risk assessment method to provide a nationally consistent approach to meeting the performance requirements of the PCA. And it will make it much easier for both practitioners and regulators to ensure that the drinking water supply is adequately protected. So let's explore a little more. It is an easy-to-follow five-step process for determining the hazard rating for individual and zone protection. These five areas are building class, as per the NCC definition in Part 6 of the governing requirements, on-site water service type, drinking water use, the cross-connection type, and the extent of the actual or potential contamination. Each area provides a score or numerical value. Scores are allocated and summed to provide a total score. 0 to 3, no hazard. 4 to 7, low hazard. 8 to 10, medium hazard. And above 11, a high hazard. It's important to note the intent of this verification method is to provide a consistent means of determining hazard ratings for situations not listed in Specification 41. The verification method is not intended to enable any lowering of hazard ratings already prescribed in Specification 41. Let's look at a couple of examples. An apartment block, 20 stories with mixed-use retail on the lower levels, and an underground car park with a car valet operation. In this example, we are to assess the zone protection rating for a basement car wash. We look into the Spec 41 and don't see it listed. So let's do the assessment. We look at the building class, and I've got here listed that it's a 2-3. Well, actually, it's probably a 6, but it gives us a score of 2. The on-site water services, network utility-operated supply water, or recycle and firewater services, gives it a score of 3. What is the drinking water use? Well, the drinking water is connected to the residential units and to the retail units and to the car wash. And the car wash may use chemicals for most for mud breaking and or waxing. So that gives us a score of 2. The cross-connection type, well, there's lots of potential cross-connections when you have the chances of untrained people doing connection. So that gives us a level of 2. And the extent of contamination. Well, this is a high-rise building. There could be more than 100 people. That gives us a score of 3. Cumulatively, we add that up, and that comes to 12, which is a high hazard. The next slide tells us an example for something you are confronted with on an everyday basis. It is a new piece of equipment that you have never seen before. So what is the hazard rating? The manufacturer says it is no danger to the water supply, so only needs low hazard protection. But a steam-powered chicken plucker? Common sense would suggest it uses cold water and maybe heated water. There are feathers and possibly blood and feces, etc. One person may think it proposes a high hazard risk in contradiction to the manufacturer's recommendations. So let's see. The building class, we review this again. 2-3 or maybe a 6 if it's a shop or a works in a shopping centre. On-site water services, network utility water service only, so we get a score of 2. Drinking water use, well, it's connected to the appliance and there is no way to determine if any internal approved backflow prevention is required. So that gets a score of 3. The cross-connection type, well, it's a small food processing facility. So we'll give that a score of 1. And the extent of contamination, again, it's a residential building with more than 100 people. So that gives us a score of 3. Cumulative score equals 11, so it's a high hazard, as might have been considered.